Hey everybody, I'm Patrick Friedman with Water Boats Bass, and we're here with Mark Franco, Diamond Valley Lake Guide. And we're gonna pick his brain a little bit about the fishing at Diamond Valley Lake. But before we get into that, let's talk to Mark a little bit about how he got into fishing and how he became a guide at Diamond Valley Lake. How'd you do that, Mark?
Wow, how did I get into fishing? Well, always dad, grandpa, 11 uncles who dragged me everywhere up and down Southern California. And I just fell in love with fishing, freshwater and saltwater. And probably around 20 years ago, I actually got hurt in construction. Fell, and I decided to start into something new. I've always fished, I've always had a passion for it. And I decided to become a guide, and 20 years, 4,000 guide trips, and I can't believe it, I'm still doing it.
That's amazing, that's really awesome. And yeah. One of the key things we want to speak today about is structure. When you go to any lake, fishing structure is huge. What kind of structure are you looking at Diamond Valley Lake?
Yeah, you bet. At Diamond Valley Lake, I'm looking for like a lot of drop-offs, a lot of ledges, points as well. And I don't know if a lot of people know this, but we have a lot of rocks on the fourth cove over to the right. I will sit in there all day sometimes and just catch bass on drop shots, Texas rigs, shaky rigs, stuff like that. You know, they got a lot of rocks in there, and that's what they did with the hospital that they collapsed back in 1996, 97. They used all that rock for the lake, and they put that structure all over. And this is just on the front end of the lake. On the west end, on the other side, it's all rocks from all the dam. You got two dams surrounding the lake there, and it's just full of rocks. And for me, that's structure. They also have some ladders that go down into the lake. Those were used for the construction workers to get to their spot when they were working on it. They decided to pull them out, but a couple of us other guys, myself and Greg Silks, we all said, you know what, leave them, they will make great structure. I'm still fishing them today. 17 years on those ladders, you can catch anything on them. That's a big secret right now, so I just shared it with everybody.
Well, that's really cool. It's mid-November right now. Weather is starting to get a little bit cooler in Southern California. What phase are these bass going into?
Yeah, they're transitioning. They're definitely going in and out with the hot we got going on, 90 degrees out there in the last few days to, you know, maybe 60 degree nights. So they're staging, going back and forth. Myself, I'm in that 20 feet of water, just kind of cruising along. That seemed to keep me really consistent. But when you're pounding the shoreline and you see a big one, you can't help but try to go after him. But unfortunately, they don't want anything to do with us right now. So kind of go back a little bit, sitting at 20 to 25 feet of water. Fishing should be really well.
That's really cool. So with this kind of in and out phase, fishing can sometimes get tough or fickle. What do you do when it gets pretty tough at DVO?
You know, it's one thing about getting fickle out there, because it can get like almost like a mill pond out there. I mean, just literally no wind, no nothing. And as us bass guys, we want a little havoc on top of that water. So I have a tendency to just go looking for it, you know. And some of the areas, the way the lake is built, you'll get these little wind pockets out there. Just keep your eyes on the water and look for it, and you'll usually do a little better. But there are some stagnant times out there, you know, from that maybe from 11:30 to 1. I think they just take a siesta.
Yeah.
And it just puts everybody to sleep. But that afternoon bite, as soon as we start getting some rocking on the water, some waves, you know, we start getting that little dirty color on the points and edges, that's when those bass really start to wake up in the afternoon. So
that's awesome. Yeah. So DVL also is known for putting out some pretty big bass. Why are the bass so big there? What makes that happen?
You know, it's got great food. We got shad, we got shiners, we got redfin, there's bluegill all over that lake. So these fish have a great diet.
That's really cool.
And at nighttime, we have night fishing tournaments out there, and they killed the rat. Ah, did I give a secret up? They killed the rat because of all the kangaroo rats that are out there.
Wow,
they get on the water. Yeah.
That's really interesting.
That's another little secret. Man, I just can't help giving them all up. So.
Okay, last thing.
Yeah, you bet.
Mark guides out of DVO. What can someone expect to, what kind of experience can they expect to have when they go out and guide with you? And also, how can they get in contact with you?
Oh, you bet. Well, you know, guiding with me is a lot of fun, folks. I enjoy it. I love sharing my passion. I love teaching and coaching. It's all I've really ever wanted to do. And to do this in fishing and get paid for it, it's a lot of fun. And we're gonna catch fish, folks. We're gonna use light tackle. We're gonna lose a few, maybe, but we're gonna catch some fish and just have a lot of fun. And if you want to get a hold of me, feel free to call Bass Pro Shop here in Rancho Cucamonga. They have my number here, 909-708-6515, or you can email me at troutchaser1@msn.com. Oh, you know what? I also have one more thing. I just started an Instagram page. Fishing with Franco.
All right, I'll be following that right now.
Fishing with Franco. So we're just getting that started. It's a little too much work for me, but I'll get into it.
Awesome. Well, thank you so much for taking the time, giving out those tidbits of information. I'll be using everybody, Mark Franco. Look him up. Fishing with Franco on Instagram. Get on a guided trip with him. He's going to put you on the fish. Thank you so much.
Oh, you're welcome. Thank you. Awesome.